Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, I didn't have giant jungle trees floating over my farm area. And in this episode, I do. In the last episode, all of these farms were the old forestry-style farms, these ones. They were like this. I've upgraded most of them to these new farms. Now, these are from the Mine Factory Reloaded mod. And I feel like I like them better. They basically use less power overall, and they do like a much larger area. As you can see, I have a lot of this wheat, and it's just a solid block of wheat. It's not like the other ones that are just a ring like these here, right? So I'm really liking these farms. And I have these tree farms set up. Now I actually just turned them all off because I want to fix this one. As you can see, I had this hooked up and I had another one up there, but it turns out that the trees would grow and actually destroy these pipes here. So I'm trying to think of a way to fix that issue, and I think I have a solution to it, but it's a little bit complicated. Basically, what I want to do is I want to come over here and then run lines up just to the outer edge of that tree there and do like a wider range. But let me go ahead and show you guys how these things work. Now, if you've watched my live streams, you'll know all about these things. But basically what happens is, well, this one actually still has power. You've got this, well, I actually don't know how to describe it. Let me just go down below first, because that's easier to explain. Let's go down right here. So down here, if we go, I feel like things are going to spawn in here. Maybe. Okay. If we go down here and we go into like the wheat farm, for example, you can see I've moved the power and everything. There's this thing called a planter, and what I'm doing here is I'm exporting seeds into this planter, and then this will plant in a 3x3 area above it unless you upgrade its range. So I've upgraded its range by 5. So it does a 7x7 area by now. So, or I think it might be a little bit wider than that. Possibly, I don't know. But basically, these all have the bronze upgrades, which make their radius increase to 5. So that's what the planters do. Now, the harvesters work in a similar fashion. You just place them on the edge of the farm, and they will harvest targeting, you know, like the center block, wherever that might be here. And these also have the same range upgrade. So that's how those work. So if I was to go over here, and let's go ahead and turn on all these farms real quick. If I could hit the levers, you'll also note that they are extremely fast in comparison to the other farms, right? So that's another reason that I like them. They're much faster to cut down the trees, and they use less power. So it's kind of just a win-win situation for this whole thing. So I do want to finish hooking up this one here. Now, the only reason that this isn't working properly is because this harvester down here can't actually reach that high. It can only reach as high as it's got so far, right? Now, there is a solution that I could just do, and that's to put a roof over this, but I think it'd be better not to do that and to just put a harvester towards the edge here and run that somewhere else that it's not going to get disrupted. So I could also do separate power up there, so I'm not running lines, and I might end up doing that, but I think for now I'll try to hook something else up. But anyway, let's go ahead and head back to the base, because there are some other things that I got done that I want to show you. Let me just throw these out of my inventory. Anything else good? Oh, you know what? Before I do that, let's head down here real quick, because I want to show you. So if you remember before, I was saving up melons, and actually I'm still saving melons, and I'll show you here. How many do we have? We have 83,000 melons. We also have 20,000 vines, and that's from those jungle trees, but what we're doing is we're actually storing them in these deep storage units, because I didn't want to make a separate drive for them, so I figured this is the next best option. So I'm saving all of these in here, and I'm actually thinking of upgrading all of my storage to use these deep storage units, just because they're so much easier to use. They don't cost very much, and they store a lot of items. I actually don't know what their upper limit is, but I kind of want to upgrade this whole system to use just those. That way I don't have to use this whole export system here. Now the other thing too that I want to do is this export system I want to replace with a system that will automatically turn off these farms over here once we reach the max number of items that we're looking for. But that's going to be done a little bit later because I still am not quite sure what how I want to do that. So for now, I've got this system, and it's working pretty well. It just basically, it voids the items when we get over a certain amount. Now, I do want to check if anything ended up here. Yes. So items, for whatever reason, keep ending up in this chest, and I keep having to toss them out. I just throw them on the ground and let them despawn most of the time. And that seems to work, but I want a more permanent solution, so I got to figure out what's causing that. But anyway, let's head back to the base, and I'll show you, there's a couple things I got done at the base. Now, if you've watched my live streams, you know all about all this stuff, but I'm going to show you anyway. Let me just eat real quick. There's a bird in here somewhere, and I can't find it. Is that it? Hey, bird. Okay. So let's go look over here. So you can see I've got some Greg Tech machines here now. I've got alloy smelter, plate bending machines, automatic wire mill, and an assembly machine. So these are all hooked up to my AE network. I've got a couple crafting recipes in each of them. This one doesn't have any. I was going to add one, but I didn't. And yeah, so I've got a bunch of stuff hooked up in here for these, and I've got the power. It's basically running up and over, and it's actually connected into this AESU. This is outputting 128. So yeah. So this way, I can just do an LV transformer and transform it down. I might switch that to high voltage or something, but for now, it is what it is. Because the only thing right now is, like, if I were to hit that plus button, that would blow up. And possibly all my machines, I'm not sure. So I don't really like that, but I don't know. That's my option for now. I do have a bunch of new auto-crafting recipes. I think the last time you guys saw, I stopped, like, here. So I've got all of these new ones, and if you want to just take a look, you can. I'm not going to go over each one. I did do tesseracts because I needed them, so I did hook up some other things over here. This setup right here, this whole thing here, I think it's this one. Yeah, the magma crucible and the liquid transposer. I have this actually configured to make the unattuned tesseract. So actually, you know what? For whatever reason, let me see if I have a tesseract frame. Let me just make one tesseract frame real quick, because, oh, what are you waiting on? Ooh, do I not have, oh yeah, it's making hardened glass. So I actually have hardened glass automated as well. I don't remember where it goes though. I don't remember. Oh, I think it's the induction smelter. I think it just finished. So let's see. Yep. Okay, so we are going to do, what was it? Tesseract. Yeah, so it made me a tesseract frame. I just want to get the ender pearl dust or ender pearl stuff out of here, so that way it goes away. Basically, that will get imported back into the system, and I'll have another unattuned tesseract. So I've got that. This system here makes tesseract frames, and then I have automated in here the next step of that, which is to make the actual tesseract. So, so that's that. I'm trying to think what else. I've been working on these bees. I've been trying to get. I think the temperature is what I was working on last time, so I was using blaze powder, I believe. Oh, I may have been using snowballs. I don't remember. But anyway, I've been just trying to get their temperature tolerance up, and then, yeah, so that's that. Now, what else? There's so many things. All of the things. I think that's about it. I think that's everything that I really did. I do have all of my ores in here set up to process, so if I ever run low on an ore or on an ingot type, I can actually craft them. So actually, if we just switch to craftable items, like if I was to say, craft me a stack of gold, right? It would actually take the gold and throw it into this here. It takes the gold dust, it makes gold dust here, and then it takes the gold dust and puts it in here. So that's how that system works. So that's that. Which is pretty neat. I really enjoy that. And what the heck? For some reason, these lights are just going crazy today. I do need to make another 64K storage. I tried to make one before. And I don't remember what happened. Okay, so I made 10 of those. Let me just make, 3 of these real quick. Okay, and let me make one of these. Okay, and let's make one of these. There we go. Yeah, for some reason, it wasn't making those before. But it is now. Okay, so it looks like that made. So if I do 64K, whoop, 64K storage, if I make one of those, yeah, there we go. Okay, so I just needed one more because I took one of these For spawn, I believe. So there we go. Now we've got our drives fill up again. Now I'm trying to figure out what I wanted to do today. I thought I had something planned. I kind of just wanted to show you guys what's been going on. These bees have been running nonstop since last time. And they're still here doing their thing. I do want to get them to be nocturnal bees. All my bees I want to get nocturnal. I've been messing around with the extra bee machines, but I haven't got too much going. I've just got this acclimatizer so far. So I did actually automate the alveary blocks. I don't know if I showed that in a video or if I did it on stream. I think I did it on stream. So actually, if you look up here, I'm making LP. I don't know what that means. It says LP on the bottom there. I'm basically making these alveary blocks, and these are being made with... I need seed oil, and I also need honey. And then down here, this is making the scented panels, as you can see here. Okay, and then this over here is making the alveary blocks. I didn't know it was making those. Okay, so it's making those, and then eventually that auto-crafts into an alveary block. I think the alveary block is actually in here somewhere. Yeah, it's right here. So it's actually a physical item that it crafts, but it's pretty simple. It's not too bad. It's pretty slow, but it's not too bad. I mean, it gets along. Now I'm trying to think what else I want to show you. Oh, I did go... Let me see. Okay, so if we go in here, if we do... What are they called? Is it net? Yeah, so I got a bunch of animals from the Twilight Forest last night. I basically caught them in these safari nets, and I have one of these spawners. Let's see. Spawner. I have one of these auto spawners, and I was messing around with it, and that's why there was that little bird over here when we first started. And I kind of want to get a mob farm started with that, but I'm not quite sure where to begin with it, and I'm also not sure where to put it. I have all this space in here, and I just don't know what I'm going to use for what. So for now, I've just been kind of lining the walls with things. I'm thinking I might make a second level, because this we're like in a hill here. So if I go up, you can see there's quite a bit of hill above me. So I might just build it in there. And there's another one of those birds. Hey. Okay. But yeah, I've been messing around with some of that. And I think what I want to do to finish this episode out is I want to make a couple more of those farms. So I need two harvesters. Let's go ahead and grab two of these. I also need two of the planters. Okay. So let's go ahead and grab two of those. Let's see, what else do we need? We need some tesseracts. We need two. Actually, we need four liquid tesseracts. No, we only need two. Okay. And actually, I did want to show you that. So back here, I think it's right here. I do have some of these. These are called sludge boilers. And what these are doing is these are taking sludge and turning it into items. And it's actually turning it into a couple different types of items. And I want to show you, but I'm being poisoned. The reason they're in the corner here is because they do poison you, and they give you the hunger effect. So I put them back in that corner because they were, like, right here. And these actually make things like clay. You can see I've got 56,000 clay. I've also got a bunch of soul sand. Actually, let's grab four soul sand and bring it with us because we're going to need it. It makes quicksand. Actually don't know what quicksand is useful for. Let me see. Because it makes a lot of items that you really can only get from like digging, and they're limited resource items. Okay, so that is basically useless. I'll probably end up voiding that. But it makes like cracked sand, which is another one of those items. I think you can get saltpeter with this. Let me see. So cracked sand makes sand or saltpeter, yeah. So this is another one of those items that you can only really get by mining stuff, and it's biome specific. So the place I've been mining in Hypno's mining world doesn't ever produce that, so I don't have any. So this is really cool as an alternate resource for that. It also produces a ton of clay, and I think I'll eventually start setting up the lithium production. I may have mentioned this before. Hang on. I gotta reset my thing. Lithium. So you can actually make lithium out of the clay dust here. And lithium produces a ton of energy. So I'm trying to do this, and I'm probably gonna end up using bees to supplement some of it, because I don't think this produces quite enough clay for that. I only have 56,000 now, and I don't know how much. I'm going to need overall. This has been running for like 2 days, so it produces like 40,000 a day or something. But yeah, I actually do want to, let me grab four of this. Actually, just one in a pattern. I just want to do something with this. Okay, encode. Let's go ahead and throw this in here, and I actually want to just clay. I want to auto-craft a bunch of this real quick. So if I do, can I just hold that? Nope. I think I can do like, there we go, begin. 4,096, that's not bad. I just want to get those crafted up because it'll save a little bit of space. It's kind of slow, but not too bad. So anyway, there's that. Let's go ahead and head to spawn. I do need, did I grab my tesseracts? I grabbed tesseracts. I do need some conduit. And I probably need some of the cable. This stuff here. excuse me. That way I can use that. I think I have everything else I need. Excuse me. Ugh. I want to hiccup, but I don't. So let's go ahead and head back. Now people keep asking me, like, in my live streams, why my books are up here. I'm just too lazy to move them. Eventually I will move them, but for now, they are where they are. It's not too big of a deal. So what I want to do... Oh, I should have brought... I have dirt here, actually. Let's just grab some dirt. Okay, I do want to dig up these farms here and replace them with these farms, right? So, trying to think. I guess the best way to do it is just to do it. So let's go ahead and break the farms themselves first. Okay. And let's go ahead and grab the other one too. All right. Now my inventory is probably full of seeds, but that's not a big deal. Oop. Alright, then I guess I'm going to dig out this as well. I only need to dig out the center area. I do need two blocks of space. Whoops. Give me this. I'm trying to think how I want to do the, the water. Actually, I don't think I need water, so never mind. I do need to figure out the pattern that I'm going to use, because they will grow, I think, only on dirt. I actually don't know how I'm going to do this. I'm kind of confused. Let's go ahead and just get this dug out real quick, and we'll see if we can figure something out. Whoops. So this is the pumpkins, or the melon side, I believe. Let's see. Yeah, melon seeds come out of here. So I'll just have to keep that in mind. Let's go ahead and tear out all of this, and... Come on, water. Actually, probably shouldn't be tearing out all the dirt. Oh well, doesn't matter. Alright, I also need to get rid of this stuff, so let's go ahead and do that now. Right, and this. Okay, and I'll leave the rest of that for now. So let's see what we want to do, because basically it's going to be... If I do like a row here and then a row here, actually probably should leave two spaces. So let's go ahead and if we do this. That's not even. That would drive me crazy. Okay, you know what we'll do? Well, let's go ahead and do this real quick. We'll go ahead and leave this like this. We can do that, and we'll just leave this center area like this. What is this? Shut up, phone! Stop it! God damn it! I can't even record when you're doing that, phone. Okay, I can't. Let's do this. I'm indecisive. Let me just rip this out real quick. I'm just gonna do it every other one, because that can grow on either side, I believe, and this works out, I think, better anyway. So let's do that. And then in between, now I don't know what they can actually grow on. I think they can only grow on dirt, which is going to be a pain, because that means I'm going to have to manually replant it. I don't actually know. I don't know. So I'm actually going to do it just like this for now, and we'll see how it goes. Actually, these can probably stay like that as well. I don't know. Let's go ahead and get the planter down here real quick, because that'll tell us for sure how it works. Okay. I have way too many melon seeds. Let me just throw these like right here real quick. Yay. Okay. All right, and what we're going to do is we're also going to put the planter. What the heck? Didn't mean to do that. The planter is going to go like right here. And the harvester is going to go there. Oops. I did forget something, but that's okay. Let's go up. Oh, can I please go up? That'd be great. There we go. So like I said, the harvester will go here. And let's rotate it. Okay. And actually, I said the planter goes here, but it doesn't. Let's go ahead and go right up here. I do need to make this a solid slab, I believe. So we'll do that. Let's get down here. The planter goes right here in the center. And I think it goes there. I hope it goes there. We'll find out, I guess. And basically, we put melon seeds in here. Now, I do need the range upgrade on this, and I forgot that as well. Let's go ahead and throw some of these melon seeds in there. Okay. Then we need power, so let's go ahead and get the power hooked up. The power needs to go down like this, and then also across like this. Okay. So this goes here. Where is steam consumer goes there. Tesseract goes here. Where's the other thing? There it is. Buildcraft producer goes here. And then I need to just wrench the direction of this so it points out of the production, right? Okay, this is all hooked up. Let's go ahead and change this to enabled high. Owner only, receive only, farm steam. Okay, and then this is gonna be number 153. Now I don't know, do I have my screwdriver? Where is it? Oh, there it is. Okay, so 153. Right. 153, set. And if we wrench this that way, there we go. Should be providing power, and that's probably already planted. Now I do need to also hook up some of this ME cable. Actually, I didn't need one there. Can I have that? That'd be great. There we go. We're gonna hook this up right over here. If I could get it down, that'd be great. Okay, and we're also going to hook it up right up to here. And I do need an interface there, but I'm not going to worry about it for now. We're basically just hooking it right into this network here. Now we're going to do an export bus, which I didn't bring with me either. Good. An export bus on there to export the melon seeds. Now let's go, if we can get up here, let's go ahead and remove this cable first. Oh, dang it. I forgot I made this all nice in here. Ooh. Alright, let's grab all of this, and let's go ahead and put the stone bricks back. Oh, I think I may have missed one, but that's okay. I'm not going to worry about it too much. Okay. Oh, there it is. Let's go ahead and just fix that real quick. There we go. Okay, so we've got all that. And the only thing that we need is one of the upgrades, but I'm actually going to steal that from another place here in just a second. I do want to finish putting this dirt down, so let's go ahead and do that. So this is going to go like that. Right. And then we'll see how it reacts to dirt. Because it didn't actually even plant anything yet, which is weird because it has power. It's right here. Very strange. Let's go ahead and grab the upgrade out of this guy for now. And we'll throw him down in here. And we'll see how he works. Oh, don't put it there. So we put it like that, and then we put the dirt over top. It's not actually working. Well, that's good. I'm glad. I don't know why. I wonder if it needs water. It might actually need water. It might only plant it next to water or something like that. Oops, that was a little too deep. Very strange. In theory, that should be working. It should be planting the melon seeds, but it's not. So, I don't know. Don't know what to do. I may be doing this wrong, so I'm actually going to go look it up real quick, and I'll be back once I figure that out. All right, well, I've looked it up, and I've tried putting water on them. I've tried putting water over the block here as well, and it doesn't seem like it's working. I've seen it work before myself, but I don't know how it worked. So I'm actually just going to leave this how it is. We're actually not in need of pumpkins or melons at this time, so I'm just going to leave it. I may be mistaken that it works at all, so if that's the case, it's not a big deal. Where did... Oh, you know what? I just never grabbed this, did I? I do want to put torches in here. We don't need mobs spawning in here. That wouldn't be ideal. So let's go ahead and make sure this is all lit up. Actually, let's throw one more back here. But yeah, I'm actually not going to worry too much about it. It kind of sucks that I couldn't get it working. But again, it's not a big deal. I'm not actually using pumpkins or melons at this time. So I will investigate that further. If you guys know what's wrong with it, like what I need to do, go ahead and let me know. And I actually just want to grab this soul sand real quick. And I actually want to put this right here. And that's what I grabbed it for. And there you go. Now it's all planted. Give me one more. And we'll be good to go. But yeah, so I'm not too concerned. I'm thinking I may just fill this all in with dirt to make it completely flat. I don't know if that's going to make any difference. You can see I threw pumpkin seeds in here just to see if they would work, but they didn't. So, don't know. Not sure what's going on with that, but at least I've got it built. If anything, like if it doesn't work at all, then I might just plant pumpkins somewhere and then have the harvester grab the grown pumpkins or something like that. Because that would still work. Like, I don't actually need the planter for this. It's just if anyone were to trample the crops, I would need to go replant them or whatever. But either way, like I said, it's not that big of a deal. I'm just going to fill this in with dirt to make it look all nice. And anyway, that's going to conclude this episode. I don't know if it's short or long or what. I didn't actually keep track of time, but I do want to thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, go ahead and leave a rating. And until next time, I will see you guys later.